This next question comes from the When to Use Via In Pad video. Check out this guy on screen. I look like I'm still in my 20s. And the question asks, how did you fan out your 0.4 millimeter BGA? Well, a 0.4 millimeter BGA refers to, of course, the pitch between the pads and the balls in that BGA. Now, a 0.4 millimeter BGA is going to have small enough pitch that you're basically going to be unable to put a standard mechanically drilled via in between the pads or in between the balls on that BGA package. And so the result is that you'll be forced to put the via for that package in order to reach the inner balls in the pad, in the PCB footprint. Now, what about with a laser drilled via?
Fire the laser!
Well, with laser drilled vias in a BGA fan out, if the laser drilled via has a small enough diameter, you might be able to fit it in between the pads and the PCB footprint so that you could do a dog bone fan out. Maybe you can do that with 0.4 millimeter pitch BGA. But generally, once you get down to 0.4 millimeters or 0.35 millimeters, like in the NRF52 wafer level chip scale package, you're gonna be forced to do via in pad, whether it's mechanically drilled vias or laser drilled vias. The reason is that the pad pitch is just too small to put most vias in between the pads in that PCB footprint. Using those very small diameter laser drilled vias, such as, for example, a 2mm via, is then going to also require that you use a 1mm thick outer layer film for that buildup layer supporting that blind via. All that's doing is adding cost to the board, and if your only reason for doing it is avoiding via in pad, I don't think that's a very good reason. So I would say use the larger diameter via because it's going to be more reliable, it's going to cost less to fabricate, and your fabrication house, if they can already handle a larger diameter laser drilled via, is certainly going to be able to handle via in pad with laser drilled vias.